Building and maintaining Maine's transportation network requires high-quality construction materials. One of the most widely used materials is aggregate, processed sands, gravels, and crushed stone. These aggregates must meet strict standards and undergo testing to assure correct particle size distribution, cleanliness, hardness, and other standards. Proper and consistent sampling is a critical step in assuring accurate test results. Maine DOT follows the American Association of State Highway and Transportation Officials' standard practice for sampling aggregate products. The sample location is sometimes determined based on how the test results will be used. For process control testing, samples are often obtained from stockpiles at the material source. Samples for acceptance or verification are generally taken close to where the material is used. For base materials, this means collecting samples from the roadway during construction. For aggregates used in asphalt or concrete, samples are collected from stockpiles at the production facility. Once the gravel is deposited onto a roadway, it is spread out and shaped with heavy equipment such as a bulldozer. Once it's been shaped, the technician must obtain the sample before the material is compacted. To collect the sample, you'll need a shovel, a tarp, and several clean sample buckets. The number of sample buckets depends on the size of the material being sampled. For roadway material, 4 buckets will usually provide sufficient material for testing. Refer to the standard test procedure for the minimum sample size. Tell the heavy equipment operator when you're ready to begin collecting the sample. It is important that the operator has made eye contact and signaled that he has seen you. Once you're confident that the equipment operator understands your intention, determine the sample location. Record the station, offset, and layer, whether upper or lower. This can be determined from the nearest grade stake or obtained from the project inspector. Place the tarp on a flat area, select 3 separate locations in the sample area, and fill 1 bucket from each location. Insert the shovel, roll it back slowly until it's horizontal, then lift it slowly to avoid losing material. Repeat as necessary. It is important to obtain material from the full depth of the layer, excluding underlying material. Next, empty the 3 buckets into the center of the tarp. When all 3 buckets are on the tarp, mix the aggregate thoroughly. It is best that 2 people mix the aggregate. When mixed, flatten the material to a uniform height and divide it into quarters. For a complete description of the quartering process, see AASHTO R76, standard practice for reducing samples of aggregate to testing size. Select one of the quarters and shovel it into one of the clean buckets. It is important not to spill materials in this process. Repeat this process with the opposite quarter and fill a second bucket. These 2 buckets will be sent to the lab for testing. The 2 remaining quarters can be discarded or saved for testing by the contractor. If additional material is needed, repeat the sampling process. Close the bucket lids tightly to eliminate contamination and to ensure nothing spills. Then, place a marking tape onto the bucket with the reference number taken from the corresponding sample ID form. It is vital that you fill out all the information on the ID forms so they can be properly tracked at the lab. With that, the sampling of aggregate from a roadway is complete, and the containers are ready to be transported to the lab. When you arrive at any pit or production facility, notify the facility personnel of your arrival and follow all the safety procedures of that facility. Identify the stockpile you need to sample and park nearby in a visible and safe location. Material segregation is bound to happen at most stockpiles, so avoid sampling directly from those areas. Using a loader to mix the material will minimize this problem. Alert the bucket loader operator of your intention to sample the aggregate in the stockpile. The loader will then go to the stockpile where the bucket should remain approximately 1 foot off the ground to avoid contamination with material from the pit floor. The bucket will then be inserted into the pile. The first bucket load is discarded. Simply set the load aside, away from your sampling location. This removes the top layer of aggregate, which will have segregated over time. Next, the bucket is inserted into the pile where the outer layer was removed. The bucket is tilted slowly up and back to avoid spilling any of the material. The loader operator will then gently roll the material out of the bucket loader, adjacent to the original stockpile, to form a new, smaller sampling stockpile. This process should be repeated one or two more times from a different portion of the stockpile. Be sure to always discard the first bucket. Now that this new smaller sampling stockpile has been established, the loader operator should slowly backdrag the pile, flattening it for the technician. From here, the process is repeated in much the same way as the roadway sampling. The technician will obtain a sample from three different locations on this flattened surface. The material is placed onto the center of the tarp where it is mixed together, divided into quarters, and placed into clean sample buckets. When sampling from a stockpile without a bucket loader, the first step is to visually divide the stockpile into thirds by volume. You should then identify three sampling locations, one from the top, one from the middle, and one from the bottom third. At each sampling location, use a shovel to remove the surface material, creating a flat shelf and an exposed vertical face. Shovel the material from this flat shelf adjacent to the exposed vertical face. Carefully place it in the bucket. Repeat this process two more times, shoveling material from the remaining two sampling locations. When you have filled all three buckets, complete the following steps, whether you are or are not using a bucket loader. With the lids firmly sealed, label each bucket with the appropriate reference number from the sample ID forms. The sample ID forms should then be completed to ensure all important details of the samples are recorded. Once the lid is securely attached to the bucket and the ID forms have been completed, everything is ready for transport to the lab for testing. This same process can also be used for sampling base or sub-base gravel for initial testing, and for coarse or fine aggregate stockpiles at asphalt or concrete plants. Collecting aggregate samples in the field is the first step to determine their suitability for use. Then samples are delivered to a testing lab for analysis. The samples are unloaded from the inspector's vehicle and spread out on a tarp to air dry the material so that surface moisture evaporates. Information from the sample identification form is logged into the testing information management system to ensure that the sample's identifying information is tracked, the appropriate tests are completed, and the test results are reported to the appropriate project personnel and contractors. Most aggregate samples undergo sieve analysis testing to determine the particle size distribution. The sample is shaken through a series of screens of decreasing size. Additional testing of the finer material may require the sample be reduced to a practical size. This is done by running the material through a sample splitter, which divides the material into roughly equal-sized portions. This is repeated as necessary to obtain the proper specimen size. Some specimens must be washed to determine the percentage of extremely fine particles. Excess fines can reduce the ability of cement or asphalt to bind to the particles and can restrict the ability of water to drain from roadway base material. The material is then dried and shaken through a stack of fine mesh sieves. Additional tests may be completed depending on the intended use of the aggregate. Once completed, results are analyzed and reported. Remember, it's important we all follow these industry standard best practices. They ensure the best possible product for our projects and ensure the safety of all involved. Thanks for watching.